Welcome on board, and today we'll dive into the topic of lifebuoys on ships, discussing their types, placement, and the SOLAS and LSA codes requirements for ships and lifebuoys. The number of lifebuoys on a ship depends on its size and type, as SOLAS imposes different requirements for cargo and passenger vessels. All lifebuoys installed on the ship have standard dimensions and weigh 2.5 kilograms each. Their design enables them to withstand a fall from a height of 30 meters and not ignite under open flame for 2 seconds. To enhance visibility during nighttime, they are equipped with reflective tape. Each lifebuoy is marked with the name and port of the ship. An important feature of the lifebuoy is the presence of a grab line attached at 4 equidistant points around the buoy's circumference, forming 4 equal loops, serves as a crucial handhold for swift and secure water rescues. On board the vessel, a significant number of lifebuoys are equipped with self-ignition lights. The lifebuoy with a self-ignition light operates automatically upon contact with water or when the device is turned vertically. This functionality is model-dependent and varies based on the specific model installed on the ship. Within this particular model, 4 batteries are housed. When the device assumes a vertical position, the contacts connect, and the light illuminates. The light emits a continuous white glow and can last for a minimum of 2 hours. Certain lifebuoys on board are additionally equipped with a buoyant lifeline, typically measuring 30 meters in length. According to regulations, the lifeline should have a diameter of no less than 8 millimeters, and the material must possess a strength of at least 5 kilonewtons while being non-twisting. A part of these lifebuoys is equipped with self-activating smoke signals. They are installed on both sides of the navigation bridge, strategically placed to ensure swift activation in case of a person falling overboard. What distinguishes this lifebuoy from others is its minimum weight requirement of 4 kilograms, compared to the 2.5 kilograms of other deck-mounted lifebuoys. Under normal conditions, the self-activating smoke signal will continue its operation for 15 minutes after activation. In the event of complete submersion underwater, it will continue to operate for at least 10 seconds. The location and type of lifebuoys can be found in the ship's fire and safety plan. If the fire and safety plan on board specifies that the lifebuoy is equipped with a line, you must ensure that the line is of sufficient length and complies with SOLAS requirements. If the plan indicates that the lifebuoy is equipped with a self-ignition light, you should check it to ensure that it is ready for use. The self-activating smoke signals installed on the lifebuoys on both sides of the navigation bridge have a limited shelf life and must be replaced every 3 years. It's crucial to understand that the self-activating smoke signal should be positioned in a way that nothing obstructs its free fall into the water. The line connecting the self-activating smoke signal and the lifebuoy should be of sufficient length, typically around 3.5 meters according to the manufacturer's recommendations. Self-ignition lights are designed to meet waterproof standards, however, the marine environment and moisture contribute to corrosion and electronic damage. Inadequate sealing can lead to water ingress, compromising the light source's performance. It's crucial to meticulously monitor all these aspects to ensure reliable functionality. The grab line is one of the first elements that captures our attention. It is crafted from synthetic material and is designed to withstand the load in accordance with SOLAS requirements. Your task is to inspect the overall condition of the grab line, ensuring that it remains intact and does not disintegrate. In the event of detecting any deterioration in the grab line's condition, it would lose the holding strength it is meant to provide. A lifebuoy in such a state can be considered unfit for use, not in serviceable condition. Many lifebuoys are equipped with a bottom plug, originally filled with foam. If this plug becomes dislodged, it poses a potential entry point for water, allowing it to accumulate inside the lifebuoy. When handling them, ensure they maintain balance and are not excessively heavy. The presence of defects, such as the dislodged plug, creates an additional opening for water to penetrate, compromising the buoy's integrity and leading to waterlogging, rendering it ineffective. Make sure the reflective material that helps it be seen is still working well. If it's faded, replace it with new SOLAS material. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and I'll do my best to assist you. Thanks for your attention.